Hey, greetings. Welcome to another episode of the almost world famous Cactus Atlas. Today, I stopped at a roadside attraction in Page, Arizona, very close to the Utah-Arizona border, known as Horseshoe Bend. I hear it's supposed to provide spectacular Instagram photo moments, and I've never seen it before, so I thought I'd stop by on this very breezy day and check it out. If you want to find out what it's like, come with me. So first things first, if you want to check out this attraction, you're going to pay a fee. It's $10, and you basically just pull off right off of Route 89, and you've got this booth right here, where you pay your fee. And as you can see, this parking lot is packed. It is a Saturday, but I've driven by this on Route 89, which is right out beyond the parking lot, many times, and this parking lot is always full, so I would not expect to find seclusion here. I don't think you're gonna find it. Now, one reason why you might consider stopping here is if you have things to do at Lake Powell or Glen Canyon Dam, this is right around the corner from that. But you may also be traveling from the Grand Canyon up to Zion. So if you're going from Arizona to Utah on Route 89, you're gonna drive right by this. So that's why I stopped today. I figured, what the heck, it's right here. Never seen it before and wanted to check it out. And if you look in the off in the distance that way, you could see Lake Powell, and Glen Canyon Dam is not really visible from here, but right down the road over there, you are gonna cross over a bridge. One thing that's really nice is they do have plenty of restroom facilities here, and I wasn't sure, so I actually made a stop before I got here to use a restroom. Had I known, this would have been a nice little rest stop. So this pathway up here is how you get over to the overlook, and you can see quite a few people walking up there today. So as you pull up to the gate, they will tell you to bring water, and you can see the signs that said the same. So I did bring a couple of bottled waters. I don't think we have too far to walk, but also if you have a drone, unfortunately you are unable to fly it here. So you can see we start with an uphill climb. It's very sandy here, pretty deep sand, and I don't think this would be very accessible. And it is very windy today, so you gotta hold on to your hat, and I apologize if the audio is bad. Doing the best I can here. And here's another view of the hill that you have to walk up to get to the overlook. I'm wondering if that is the overlook right there. Let's go find out. I am really excited to see this. I've seen this in pictures many times and I've always wondered about this place, and it looks like I'm right on the cusp. Oh, actually, maybe not. I just saw where we're going. You can see way down there is the actual overlook. I believe I read that it's about a 1.5 mile round trip. So this isn't too bad. The worst part about it, I think, is just the loose sand getting in your shoes. But so far, walking downhill is pretty easy. Walking back up shouldn't be too bad, but we'll see. And the crowds are pretty much constant going both directions. And just to give you an idea about the trail and the sand here, I mean, it is like walking on a beach. It's that thick. So if you've ever worn sneakers with socks at the beach, it's not a great feeling. So that's exactly what this is like here. And we're getting closer. You can see it's gonna switch to a paved trail here in just a second, which is very welcome at this point, but we're just gonna wind right down there, and I could see a huge congregation of people getting their Instagram photos. And I was incorrect, by the way. This is not paved, it's just gravel, but way better than walking in sand. I'm pretty sure off in the distance there, I think those are the Vermilion Cliffs, which I drove by on my way to the north rim Grand Canyon, which takes a slightly different route from 89 before you get up to Page here. And just a perspective of where we came from, you could see way up on the hill over there, that's that little shaded ramada that people were standing at that I initially thought was the overlook. So you can see you do have to walk a little ways to get down here. I do see people of all ages, fitness levels, children and old alike braving this, so it's really not that hard of a walk. You just have to not mind getting some sand in your shoes, really, is all about it is to me. I am so close now. I see the abyss opening up in front of me. What wonders shall await? Dun dun dun. Dun dun dun. dun 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 dun. Oh yes, Horseshoe Bend. Would you look at that? Maybe a challenge finding a good spot for your Instagram photo here at the railed area. But if you're brave, you can walk up to the edge of the abyss and peek over. Campers down there. That seems cool. So right behind me there is like a perfectly vertical drop straight down. So you gotta be really careful being here, but oh, it's a really nice view. What's scarier to me are these crowds and trying to sneak in my spot here to try to get a selfie. That's the frightening part. Nobody's standing here, I wonder why. This seems like a good spot. I guess it's not the greatest spot. There is sand blowing in my face right now. Not sure if you saw that, but people were spitting sand out of their mouth because I just got sandblasted in the face. At the edge of the precipice, I'd be very careful here because the sand is very slick on the stone. So you do get some partial views anyway from off to the side, but I'm guessing where the rails are your best bet. As you can see, I've seen portions of it. I really haven't seen the full thing at once to get that money shot. I'm standing a few feet away from this edge, and like I said, it is straight down. It's very gusty. I don't have the courage. I got about 2 or 3 feet away from the edge, and that's all I can do. But if you can get close here in this spot, you can actually get almost the whole thing. But I do think that the railed area is probably your best bet. This looks like it has a little bit of promise if I'm brave. Oh yeah, there you go. There we go. So the river, there is the Colorado River. It's carving through Glen Canyon, which is this canyon here that we're seeing. So yeah, same Colorado River that cuts through the Grand Canyon. Kind of hard to get selfies from over here. I'll give you my best duck face. I think I need training on how to do a proper duck face. I'll work on that for next time. So yeah, if you venture off this way, you do get decent views, and there are a lot less people over here. It's just a little scary. It's so gusty today, so standing on the edge of the precipice while trying to film, hold onto my hat, makes for kind of a white-knuckled experience, really. So I turned around, to be honest with you. I am getting blasted by sand. It stings. It's really windy, and trying to go back over there, the wind seems relentless, so it seems pointless to try to film with that much wind. So I'm gonna turn back and go see if I can check out the main viewing area just to see if that money shot exists over there. And you can see heading back this way, it's a madhouse. So many people. It's gonna be a challenge to squeeze in there, but I gotta do it. Sometimes you gotta wedge yourself in there. Let's see if we can get in there. I think I found us a spot. And there you go. I achieved my goal. I think I got the money shot right there. So without a doubt, I think the best spot to get a photo is like right there in that corner over there. But all of these spots here are really good. So you can definitely go walk over there and get some decent views, but right here is where the money happens. As I will show you one last time. Cha-ching. Okay, so that's all I can take. I was getting blasted by sand. When you stand over there, the wind is blowing up from in that canyon, and there are grains of sand blowing in your face. I got it in my eye, in my mouth. Still got some stuck in there, but it was worth it though. So if you can tolerate a sandblasting, you might want to come check that out. And now to head back up the hill. So let's see how challenging this is. I don't think it's going to be too bad. So as for the view, is it everything I thought it would be? It absolutely was. That was actually better than you could experience in a photo or a video like this. Really amazing to see in person. The weird thing was the river was very green, almost like algae-like green in there, which made it really pretty contrasting with the red cliffs. I'm not sure if it's always that green or if it was just my imagination, but really cool, really neat. Re-entering this sand, this beach that I gotta walk through. I can see people shaking their feet. Ugh. I can't stress how much how sandy this is. So if you take anything away from this video, if you could prepare to bring sandals or some kind of proper footwear, I would highly recommend it. I didn't know about the sand. I mean, I can handle much worse, but yeah, it's gritty. Almost there. But I can tell you, this is not that strenuous, so very easy. Okay, I am back. I'm gonna have to do my final thoughts from inside the car. It is so gusty and windy out there. In fact, I'm not even sure at this point how usable this footage will be because of the audio, but we'll try. Anyway, enough said. What do you need to know about this place? It is awesome. Now, the one thing I can tell you that does kind of suck is the trail. It's not hard to climb, but it is sand. Deep sand, like beach sand. As you can see, I had to empty out my shoe at the end to dump sand out. So come prepared, bring sandals or something. Just don't wear sneakers and socks. You may not be happy afterwards. And I imagine it's probably windy up here often being on this plateau. Today was absolutely gusty. When you get down there, there's a bunch of sandstone, and I truly, truly got sandblasted in the face, in the mouth, and other people around me, you could see them going, you know, spitting out sand and that grit in your mouth. I got some in my eye at one point, and I was genuinely worried about my camera at some point. I was like, I don't want to scratch my lens here. Maybe today was an exceptionally windy day. I don't know, but I imagine that could happen here, so maybe be careful and maybe leave your hat in the car. As for the view though, as for the vista, was it all worth it? Heck yes, it was worth it. That was amazing. That view was beautiful. Pictures don't do it justice. You've probably seen pictures of that before on the internet, but that was absolutely spectacular. Highly recommended. Maybe if you're driving through on Route 89 going to or from Arizona or into Utah or back and forth and you haven't stopped here, it's right off of 89. So you just pull up, give them your 10 bucks and you're in. Maybe consider it a rest stop. If you have to use the restroom, stop in here, use a restroom, go check out the vista, get a couple of pictures and head on out. Probably plan on spending maybe about an hour here, if that. Depends on how fast you walk, depends on how many pictures you take and how crowded it is. Oh, on the note of crowds, you saw for yourself. Absolute madhouse. I imagine it's this crowded often. This is an international destination, very popular photo spot. So expect a lot of people, as you saw today. If you're new here, please subscribe to our channel. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Also, ring that notification bell to stay on top of whenever we release new videos, which we're doing all the time. Also, you could find us on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram under the name Cactus Atlas. Well, I gotta get home, so I'm out of here. Hope you enjoyed this one. We'll have a new adventure for you right around the corner. Until next time, take it easy.